So I'm going to start with the most simple of the demos, and it will be the console solution. And then I will do the WinForms, and I will switch to Jose so he can do a summary one that is a little more comprehensive. So let's just quickly review this. We have a SAF application, a normal SAF application right here that let's quickly set it as the start project and let's run it. That pretty much is the same concept that Dave was showing, like with admin user, and right here you can see that all the permissions are being created, navigation, member type, all the good stuff. So let's just run it. And then we'll see that we're running as an admin. We're gonna have a class that is called department, and then we're gonna have employee. And because we're an admin, and Dave was explaining, if you have that is administrative boolean, you have access to everything, we can see everything that we are here. But if we log off and we come back with the user, you'll see, that the user doesn't have access to the department. So you cannot see it. And it has some criteria because it can see some of the departments, only the research and development department, that is the department that they belong. So let's try to see this in a console application. That is the more simple example. If you see here in the designer that Dave was showing, they already have there and SAF, when you do the wizard by default that you select, I want to add security and want to add the client mode, it creates all this code behind the hood for you. So let's see right here, we have created an instance of the authentication standard, then we're gonna select in the security strategy complex, and right here we're passing what are the type of users, permission policy user, permission policy role that we're going to use, and we're passing the authentication standard. Right here we could have another class that is inheriting from permission policy user and actually using that one instead of permission policy user, because the parameter that the security strategy needs is user type, role type, and the authentication base. In this case, it's going to be our authentication standard and that one. And I want to also point out that the most common approach is the one who Dave showed about inheriting from a permission policy user, but you can also implement all the interfaces that the permission policy user provides, and you will have the same functionality if you want to do some, like a few years back, we were trying to use this in Xamarin, and we couldn't inherit from base object. We needed to be only XPO. So we did that instead of inheriting from permission policy user, we implemented all the interface and inherit just for a HPO class that could run on Xamarin. So after that, we pretty much get our connection string. We create a new secure object space provider, and we pass our security strategy and our connection string, create our users. And then in the authentication, we send the logon parameter and we pass our username that will be user and the password that we have. And pretty much this part is just to create a text file and pass the objects and the of the employees and departments. So we see if they have access, if they can read, then we're gonna show it there. But if they don't have permission for that, we're gonna show the asterisk. And let's run it, let's see what happens. As long as you understand all the steps involved about authentication standard, security study, and controlling the Windows stuff for a second, you will be able to reuse this in any .NET application, any .NET core. So it's just more important about understanding how the security system API is working. You see, the file was created, you can go and read it. So right now, pretty much, let's go and check our file. I went to the other window. Let's go to the bin, the bug, and let's find the result.txt. You see here, we are saying the user was the one who logged on, and we're gonna have the list of employees here. And we already have displaying, he cannot read the department unless that is the research development department and development department. So again, all these steps is all is needed. And we're gonna be able to see this today in console, in Windows, in web, in Blazor, in Xamarin. And actually Jose has a really nice surprise in Uno as well. So that's how most rich that security system have. So let's again close this one. And now let's see WinForms. Went to the other monitor as well. So WinForms, again, we have our program. And here you see, we are repeating the same step. our authentication standard, our security complex, and our connection stream, our object space provider, that it will be the secure object space provider. So give us an object space, and then we go to the main form and we pass that security and that object space provider. If we go to the main form right here, then we are going to see that right now we are actually, let me see, we're creating a login form here that is going to be able to do that, and we're going to pass our list. And if we go to the login form, then we have the same thing, the security strategy complex, and we're going to create the login space. We're going to pass the username, the password, and do the authentication. We're going to set the login parameter. So it's exactly the same kind of steps. And again, this is available already in the landing page for the security system. So you'll be able to just go there, download the projects and run it. I actually separated, so I have all the projects with the same, if you see, we have the same SAP solution here included together. So I will also put this in my repository. So you can wanna take a look, you are welcome to go. So right here, just a WinForm application, and we have again, employees and same thing. You can only see what they are allowed to see. So we are reusing the same permission that we already set in our SAP application in a non-SAP app. I don't know you guys, but I think that this is amazing. And actually, I don't know if you guys have dealt with the ASP.NET, for example. Right now, the Microsoft Identity new approach, I like the new things that they are doing. But right now, every time that we have to do the identity through the Microsoft platform, it was just not my cup of tea. This one is a beauty, in my opinion. So with that one, I will let Jose then present a Xamarin demo, and then I will come back with a Blazor and with a web forms. So we see that, again, just follow these steps of how the security system in SAP work, and you can go and check inside. Again, if we go on in the module, if we can start checking okay, of course it will. So right here, we're gonna have our authentication standard or security study complex. So SAP is doing that for us already. So it's taking care of all that boilerplate code. But if you understand it, you will be able to reuse it anywhere. Let's then quickly review. And again, it will be a little bit more of the same, but I just want to show that you can use it everywhere. So right here, this is our web form application. We have the default. And if you see here, the things start to be the same. Security strategy complex, and then the object space, the logon, then you pass, and so on, so on, so on. So let's just run it and see that it will have the same behavior. And in the case that Jose was showing about the Xamarin, the only important part is that you need to have a web API, a middle tier, that where all of these settings is happening. You cannot do it right there in the client. Like if you're using some type of JavaScript that you're doing, like Blazor WebAssembly, those where we need that REST service in the middle. But right here, again, same concept. We have authentication standard, we have our security strategy complex, we have our type of permission policy user, permission policy role, and the same exactly behavior. Only the department that they are belong to, it will show, nothing else. So that's web form. What else can we see about the security system? We can definitely go and check Blazor. And in Blazor, it's a little more comprehensive example, but if you go to the landing page from the security system and you click, okay, let's see the demo, it will have here all the steps and where it's being implemented. It's being, you have to add security system with the security type permission and role. And then you will have, again, a service where you are at the option of the secure type. Then you will have the data store provider, and let's see it. Let's go back to, and let's close the web form version because this one was really simple. And let's see the Blazor one. Then here you have again the security provider where it's doing the authentication, the type, the policy user, the security strategy. So as much as you can understand how SAP is using that API to authenticate and to protect your data, you will be able to use it anywhere. Most probably in the future, we will be able to use it in a watch, in a fridge, anywhere where you want to sign something. I don't know, some crazy thing like that. But again, we can run it. And of course it will fail probably. Let's see why. Maybe I have something else running. Let me just recompile it. Okay, let's see. I think that I have to close Visual Studio and open it again. So while that, well, I will come back to the Blazor example. But let's see a few other things that we can do with the security system. So we were talking about all the steps with Blazor. This is really here, all the things that we need. But we also have already the official support for how to change database and runtime. And this is already released by DevExpress. We did a workaround. Meanwhile, we get this one, but this is the right approach. Things that also we can use, how to register a new user, restore a password. All of those things are already there for us. And one example is this restore password. That if we click there, it will, like, this is an old example that is being adapted. I have adapted every time that there is something new. And right there, you can restore the password. You can create a new account without having to have a manager taking care of those. Let's wait for it. So right here, you can put your email here and it will send you an email with a new password. And then when you click on it, it will have the change logo on next sign on. So that way you can just add the new password that you need. And this one that is not working because this is an example that I need to update. It's also a great example of the capabilities that we have with the SAF security system. Let's wait for it. There is no limitation in any point. You can do Azure Active Directory. You can do Facebook, Google, Instagram, Shopify, what name it. If you see here, and forget about, this is a little out of order because I have to update this example, but we have Google, Microsoft, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, anything. If you click there and it takes you to the login screens there and it creates the user for you in the system. And if you're using Active Directory, you can even check the name of your role and map it to the role that you have in SAF. So the limitations are none. Find a standard that works with the security system of SAF and go for it. You are be able to use it in any platform, in any device, and you'll be good to go. And let's now reopen the Blazor example because that one I like it. I'm kind of now in love with Blazor, I will have to say. Let's give it a second. Okay, same thing again. We were talking about everything that we need to do, authenticate security strategy complexes, secure object space. So all the steps are there, the same one that we were doing in WinForms, in console. How about that?
See if IIS is running in your taskbar there and just kill it in your system tray. They're not there, eh?
Let me just close all my other projects and that's it. Sometimes you'll see. Okay. Yeah, he's coming. So again, it's the same demo, but it's in so many platforms, in so many places that it's a beauty, in my opinion. Again, that it's hard for me to use a new application and don't go for the security system of SAF because I already know that one completely. So if you have tried to use any other type of authentication, you will see how cumbersome it becomes. At least there is a big learning curve in there. One thing that I'm dying to try is using the Azure AD B2C because I'm using that right now for a Xamarin application and nice addition to SAF. So in that regard, we also have, and then I pass it to Jose again, and then we confirm this official example that if you see, it's already in SAF Blazor and it's authenticating with all these providers that they are really useful for a lot of people. So again, really nice example, really nice options that we have here, GitHub, Azure, Google, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Shopify. What is there? We can put it there. So, and in that regard, Jose will show it in one of the, I would say, of the frameworks or one of the tools that is not common, like at least in, too much, like it's Uno. Uno is a way to using the XAML from UWP to target mobile applications and even WebAssembly nowadays. So even there, everywhere where .NET runs, SAP security will run.